Okay, dear students, let us continue our session. We can consider take it, dear students, how to write the IUPAC nomenclature for a particular coordination compounds, dear student. This is very important here. Naming of coordination compounds. What is the student? Naming of coordination compounds. Okay, dear student, just have a check it here. Okay, now let us take with respect to here. Generally, now we are having the different types of the different types of the names also there. For example, if it cationic is there, next one anionic complex is there, for example neutral is there, how we have to write this one, we have to check it. Now let me start with here. Anything you can consider, different examples we have to consider, am I correct? Now I am going to give only the three rules, am I correct or not? Three formulas also you can consider here. Now if you take it generally, for with respect to I am taking here like a case one. For negative, RL can consider here. For anionic complex, if we consider anionic complex, if we consider for the anionic complex, what you have to do it? Anionic complex means generally you have to identify how we have to write anionic. Generally take it, dear student. K4, FeCN 6 times. Am I correct or not? K4 FeCN 6 times. Now generally, sir, how we are considered as this is called as anionic complex, sir. This is comes under, dear students, anionic complex. Check it here. Each potassium atom, what is the charge? Plus 1. What is the charge total? 4 plus or not? 4 plus. Next one, this is a 4 plus. That means here, what is the charge of this complex, dear student? 4 minus or not? 4 minus. This is called as complex. The complex having the negative charge, that's why it is called as anionic complex. Now in that anionic complex, how to write here? Simple thing, you have to take it here. If it there like here, first you have to write the metal name. First you have to write, what is, dear student? Metal. I am writing here. Formula. How to write the formula for this one here? Simple one. One or two example if you done it, then you can understand easily. Metal plus, next one, you can consider here coordination number. What is the coordination number here? 6. Next one, you can go for here ligand. You can go for, what is the, dear student? Ligand. Just I am going to give only the three formulas, that's all. Apart from that, I am not going to give anything here. Metal plus coordination number plus ligand. Next one, what is, dear student, here? Next one, you can consider here, metal. Central metal atom. Central metal atom. Next one. Central metal atom fit having the, what is the charge? In the negative charge, what I have to add the, suffix, dear student? 8. Am I correct or not? 8. In the bracket, we have to write the oxidation number. What is, dear student, you have to write in the bracket? Oxidation number. Simple one. Sir, how like we have to remember, sir? Nothing is there. Just we have to check it. Metal, that is called as here, this metal called as a counter ion. This ion, it is called as, dear student, counter ion. I can write it here instead of that one. Counter ion plus coordination number plus ligand plus central metal atom. Plus we have to, because it is an anionic complex, means 8, we have to add the suffix plus its oxidation number. That's all. Check it here. I can start with here counter ion. What is the counter ion, dear student, here? Potassium. And very important here, sir, there are 4 potassium atoms there, no sir? In that 4 potassium atom, I can write tetrapotassium, wrong. How many potassium atoms, even 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there, you no need to write anything here, buy or try or, try. Am I correct? Only we have to write, here only. In the ligands only we have to write. Got the clarity? Now potassium, I wrote as it is potassium. Plus this is got over, no? Counter ion over. Next one, coordination number. What is the coordination number? 6 or not? Potassium okay next one I can write here hexa am I correct or not hexa now always in okay coordination compounds one point you have to write okay you should not write any capital letters and should not give any gap between the two letters any gap between the two letters potassium hexa over next one what type of ligand this is cno you can write here hexa okay cyanido it's also called as cyano I already okay give the list okay potassium hexa cyanido okay next one over up to here coordination number over ligand also over next one central metal atom who is the central okay iron here iron you will write no we have to add the suffix 8 iron is there ferrum is there ferrate zinc is there zincate copper is there cuprate correct because it is comes under anionic complex now I am writing here okay ferrate first to calculate the oxidation state here already we done it here plus 4 each potassium plus x plus 6 into minus 1 is equal to 0 that implies I can take it x is equal to plus 2 oxidation state or not plus 2 okay ferrate 2 this is the IUPAC okay name of this particular complex don't get confused dear student okay very easy manner okay this is the one okay next one I can consider here example number 2 okay K3 okay Fe CN 6 times here also the same thing okay first I have calculating oxidation state already done it plus 3 plus x plus 6 into minus 1 is equal to 0 that implies x is equal to dear students plus 3 or not correct now how to do it here just take it here okay now I'm writing start with here potassium okay how many okay this one is there coordination number hexa I can write here cyano or cyanide anything I wrote here now cyano potassium hexa cyano okay what is the charge negative no here what is the charge dear student 3 plus here what is the charge complex 3 minus anionic no hexa cyano okay ferrate okay oxidation state 3 oxidation state 3 this is the way you have to write oxidation state correct or not okay next one I'll consider one more example here so that we'll understand easily okay next one example 3 if you take it here am I correct dear student okay now so okay I can take it here Cr C2O4 taken thrice 3 minus am I correct or not dear student okay if you take it this one check it anionic complex I'm writing here starting with okay there is no okay front okay if this charge is there or else we can write any okay metals here but there is no counter ion instead of that counter ion I wrote here 3 minus am I correct then how to write dear students here try okay how many 3 is there no try this is called as oxalate how it will be convert oxalato try oxalato try oxalato okay now chromate okay oxidation state here 3 okay minus or plus it is called as okay ion minus or plus it is called as dear student ion sir how 3 comes sir just take it I am calculating oxidation state here x plus 3 into each oxalate ion what is the charge minus 2 or not 3 into minus 2 is equal to what is the charge dear student minus 3 that implies here x minus 6 is equal to minus 3 x is equal to plus 3 or not x is equal to plus 3 check okay try oxalato okay chromate okay 3 ion is the minus or plus is there that is we have to write the final ion got the clarity okay next one if you take it here one more example understand Na2 okay PtCl6 Na2 PK PtCl6 times okay now first let me calculate the oxidation state here plus 2 plus 6 minus okay plus 6 into minus 1 is equal to 0 am I correct I can write directly here x is equal to plus 4 x is equal to dear student plus 4 correct now let me write here okay sodium first no okay sodium am I correct sodium then we can go for okay coordination number 6 hexa okay Cl means how to write dear student chlorido Br means bromido iodido okay like that we have to write okay sodium hexachlorido okay now plati check it here what is the charge? Each one having the plus 1 here, 2 into plus 1 plus 2 is charged here, student, here 2 minus. That means anionic complex or not? Okay, that means you have to write platinate oxidation state 4 or not? Platinate 4. This is the way we have to write okay for anionic complex. Okay, next one more example again, if we consider H2. Okay, now PT, understand dear students, okay, Cl, okay, 6 times, you can take it, H2, okay, this generally we have to, okay, take it in small example here, okay, calculate the oxidation state here, each hydrogen plus 1, no, okay, plus 2, plus x, okay, next one, 6 into minus 1 is equal to 0, then I can write here directly, x is equal to dear students, plus 4, am I correct or not? Sir, then how like we have to write the oxidation state of this complex? Okay, now if you take it here, okay, now you can start here, we should not write because it is not a metal, it's not okay, understand? Then we have to start with the coordination number hexachlorido, okay, hexachlorido, then finally we have to write here platinic acid. Okay, sir, oxidation state, if you want to mention, you can write here. You can mention in the bracket 4 also. Okay, hexachlorido, okay, platinic acid. Then oxidation state, that means you can write here also. Platinum, okay, you can write platinic acid 4 also, you can mention. Like that also, no problem itself. Okay, this is about, dear student, okay. Now, okay, anionic complex. Just few examples I have been, okay, given to you. Okay, next one. If you take it one more small example, Ni, okay, Cl4, 2 minus, NiCl4, 2 minus. Now let me write here, oxidation state, first of all, x plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to what is, minus 2, that implies x is equal to, directly I'm writing here, plus 2. X is equal to, dear student, plus 2. Now let me start with here, okay, 4 chlorine, okay, chlorine, no, then I can write here, tetrachlorido, I can write here minus, directly is given anionic, okay, nickel become nickelate, okay, oxidation state 2, no, 2 ion, tetrachlorido nickelate 2 ion, this is the name, okay. Now I will start with here case 2, understand here student, case 2, in that case 2, okay, anionic over, no, next one I can take it here for cationic complex. What is dear student? For cationic complex, same, nothing is there. Okay, now 8 will not come, that's all. 8 will not come. If you take it one example, you can easily understand here. CuNH3 4 times Cl2. CuNH3 4 times Cl. Sir, how we have to recognize whether it is positive, okay, cationic complex or anionic complex? Simple, okay, if it there here front, then we can consider this is a plus, no, obviously the charge of the complex become negative. But any, okay, non-metals, okay, if it present, okay, right side of the coordination sphere, generally we have to consider that is cationic complex. Due to here, each and every chlorine, what is the charge? Minus 1 charge. Here 2 into minus 1, what is the, dear student? 2 minus or not? Here 2 minus, that means what is the charge of this complex here? 2 plus. Plus 2, minus 2, both cancel, that's why it is neutral. Then we can write here, first of all, how to write here? Okay. Now, okay, formula I am taking here. Formula of this complex. Let me start here for formula, coordination number first. Okay, because there is no metal, okay, like a counter ion front. Okay. Next one you can consider here, ligand. Correct. Coordination number plus ligand. Then after you can go for here, central metal atom and oxidation state in the bracket. Whenever you are writing the central metal atom, you must write oxidation state in the, okay, open brackets. Plus, okay, any counter ion is there, we have to write counter ion. Okay, what is the point of difference between these two? If you check it here, okay, in anionic complex, counter ion came, okay, in the front. But in case of here, okay, cationic complex, counter ion came the last. Am I correct? check it here, count coordination number, same here, coordination number, same, ligand, same, central metal atom, same, in the bracket oxidation, okay, state 8 only here added extra, but here 8 is not there, am I correct? Okay, now let me take it here, okay, coordination number here, 4, we can write here, tetra, am I correct or not? What do you have to write, dear student? Tetra. Here NH3 we have to consider as in generally NH3 means what is, dear student? Ammonia. Correct or not? But in coordination compounds we are writing here A, MMINE. We have to write amine. AMMINE and AWM we have to go. But in organic, if you take it here, RNH2 amines, AMINE. But in case of here, dear student, AWM will come. Okay, that is the difference. Tetra, I can write here, AMMINE, tetra amine, okay, tetra over, next one ligand amine over, next one come to the central metal atom. What is the central metal atom? Copper, no? Copper we have to write, we don't change anything, 8. Oxidation state, let me calculate here, X plus copper, plus 4 into each amine, okay, each ammonia, it is comes under neutral, 0. Plus 2 into each chlorine atom, what is the charge? Minus 1 is equal to 0, that implies X is equal to plus 2, correct or not? X is equal to, dear students, plus 2, okay. Now copper, okay, copper in the bracket, what is the oxidation state? Okay, 2. And what is the this one, dear student? Here also, did you write here tetrapotassium or okay, tripotassium? No, there also you should not write, am I correct? Okay. Tetra amine copper 2, that's all you have to write, chloride, don't write dichloride, that is a wrong one, incorrect, correct or not? Tetra amine copper 2 chloride, tetra amine copper 2 chloride, this is the IUPAC name for cationic complex, got the clarity, dears? This is the example one. Okay, next one, if you take it here, example number 2, understand? Okay, now Let me take it here. CO NH3, okay, 4 times NH3, 4 times here. Cl, next one Br, I can consider here, understand? Cl Br over, okay, or else you can take it here different also, okay, I can take it here, this is the, what is the, dear student? 5 times I consider here Cl, okay, so I know Br 2, I think it's Br 2, just check it here, same coordination, first of all oxidation state X plus 5 into this is 0 and this is minus 1, here outside also what is the student, okay, bromine is there, bromine, each bromine minus 1 charge, 2 into minus 1, minus 2 is equal to 0, that implies X is equal to, dear students, plus 3, X is equal to, dear students, plus 3. Now I can write the IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, this one. Check it here. Let us start with here coordination number. Okay, this is check. If any more than one different types of the ligands are present in the complex. What I said? More than one different complex, different kind of different kinds of the ligands are there. Sir, when what we have to write first, sir? Okay, either we have to write amine or first of all, okay, Cl amine. We have to follow with respect to alphabet order. What is here, student? Alphabet or alphabetical order we have to follow for different ligands are present. Different ligands are present in the complex. Check it here. Amine is there. Next one, chlorine is there. Okay. Which letter will come first? A will come. That's why we have to write first A. Then after chlorine, what is will come? C. That is we have to write last. Then I can write, dear students, here. Okay, penta, okay, NH3 called as amine or not? AMMINE, pentamine, okay. Next one, go for other ligand. What is there other ligand? Cl. Cl we have to write here, chlorido, pentamine, chlorido. Okay, next we can come for, check it here, coordination number over, ligand over. Next one, go for central metal atom. What is the central metal atom? Cobalt. Okay. Cobalt, oxidation state, dear student, plus 3, cobalt 3, what is this next one, comes under counter ion, next last one, cobalt 3, okay, bromide, what is the student, cobalt 3, okay, bromide. This is the IUPAC name for, okay, this complex. Got the clarity, dear student? IUPAC name of this complex. Okay, next one. Some more examples also we have to discuss, because this is the very important. If you are, okay, having the real confusion, okay, how to calculate oxidation number and how to write the name, okay, this one, okay, we are you will be facing the problem while studying coordination compound. First of all, you have to get the full clarity, okay, calculate oxidation number and as well as writing nomenclature of the compounds. Okay, students, okay, we can continue. Please note down. Okay, students, okay, now so far we discuss anionic and as well cationic. Next one more small, okay, two more examples I'm going to give, okay, for getting more interest. Okay, second example in cationic. Third example, okay, now you can consider here Cr H2O four times, H2O four times, again consider, okay, take it like this also. This complex Cr, okay, NH3 taken thrice, H2O taken twice, Cl SO4. Am I correct? Just check it, dear students. Based on this one, how we have to give the name of this compound. Am I correct or not? Okay, now different ligands are there or not? Yes, different ligands. It is comes under heteroleptic complex. Okay, now oxidation state, first I'm calculating here chromium. That implies here X plus 3 into 0 plus 2 into, okay, because amine, okay, ammonia and as well as water comes under, dear students, neutral ligands. Each one here, chlorine minus 1. Okay, here sulfate ion, what is the charge, dear student? Okay, minus 2 is equal to 0. Am I correct or not? So how it is comes under here, okay, cationic complex. Already we know sulfate, what is the 2 minus, then obviously what is the charge will get? Plus. Okay, now that implies I can write here X minus 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to, dear student, plus 3 or not? X is equal to plus 3. Now I am writing the name of this compound. Okay, three different ligands are there. Then we have to follow according to alphabet order. Correct? Okay, NH3 is there, we can write here amine. H2O, how it is there? H2 is there, we can write here aqua or aquo. Am I correct or not? This is the name already we written in the neutral ligand. Correct? Then we start with here. This is amine, this is, okay. Now NH3 means what is, dear student? Amine, that is NH3. Cl called as Cl chlorido. According to alphabetical order, will win which one? Here also A, here also A. But what is the next letter? M. Here what is the next letter? KQ. This one will come first. Correct or not? Then you can take it here. Okay, tri amine. Okay. Next one here, how many is there? Two water molecules are there. I can write here. Di aqua or aquo. Anything. Di aqua. Next one. Cl means what is the, dear student? Chlorido. Up to here comes under ligands only. Okay, tri amine, di aqua, chlorido. Okay, next one, go for, okay, central metal atom here. What is chromium? Okay, oxidation state here 3. Chromium 3. The SO4 it is called as, dear student, sulfate. SO4 called as, dear student, sulfate. This is the, okay, nomenclature for this compound. Okay, tri amine, di aqua, chlorido. Chromium 3 sulfate. Chromium 3 sulfate. Okay. Next one. Okay, I'm taking here one more example. You can take some different examples you can consider here. Zn NH3 four times 2 plus. This is the cationic complex, no? You can start with here this one. Okay, tetra amine. What is the student? Tetra amine. Next one, immediately you have to go for, okay, central metal atom, zinc. Zinc, zinc valent we have to write. Zinc. Okay, what is the charge here? Oxidation state, dear student, X plus 4 into 0 is equal to plus 2. Then implies here X is equal to plus 2. Correct or not? Zinc 2, what is this one here? Ion. Zinc 2. Zincate won't come. Why? Why we have, okay, zincate will not come, dear student. This is not comes under, okay, anionic complex. It is comes under cationic complex. This is the way we have to. Okay, next one. Very important is this one, dear student. For, okay, case number 3. For neutral complex. What is dear student for neutral complex? Generally it is called as unionized complex. It will not form any type of ions. Okay, now let me take it here, same example. Okay, one more example I am taking here. Ni CO 4 times. What is dear student? Ni CO 4 times. Now how to write? First of all, calculate oxidation number here, nickel. X plus 4 into, already I told this is the concerned neutral. That implies here X is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. The same thing. Okay, what I have to write here? Tetra. Okay, CO we have to consider carbonyl. Tetra carbonyl or carbonyl. Okay, now what is here? Nickel. Oxidation state, dear students, 0. Oxidation state of nickel also you have to mention for, okay, in case of neutral complex. In case of neutral complex, don't get confused. Understand, dear student? Next one, example number 2 I am taking here. Fe, okay, CO 5 times. Fe, CO 5 times. Let me calculate same oxidation. Whenever the CO comes, oxidation state 0. Because it is a neutral. X plus 5 into 0 is equal to 0. That implies X is equal to, dear students, 0. Am I correct? Now I can write it here. Okay, first of all, how much here? 5, no? 5 I can write here. Penta carbonyl. Penta carbonyl. Okay, what is this one? Here, as it is, you have to write. Don't write any type of nickelate, zincate, platinate. Because, okay, for anionic complex only we have to add the suffix 8. Have you all understanding, dear students? Okay, penta carbonyl. Okay, what is this one? Okay, Fe means ion only, no? Ion 0, that's all. Pentacarbonyl, ion 0. This is the, okay, what is the, dear students? Okay, IUPAC name of this compound. Got the clarity? Case 1, case 2, case 3, over. Okay, if anionic is there, how to write? Cationic is there, how to write? Okay, next one, in case of, okay, neutral is there, how to write? Everything we wrote. And one more, okay, one more also there, very important, that is called as an examination point of view. Case number 4. Okay, for both complex containing both cationic and anionic species. What is the student? This also very, very important. Okay, what is complex containing both cationic and anionic complex? Am I correct, dear student? If it there, okay, then how to write this one here? Just I am checking one example. Very, very important, dear students, here. Example number 1. Okay, now take it here. Like this I am taking. Okay. Cr H2O 6 times. Cr H2O 6 times. Okay, next one. CO Cl6. CO Cl6. Whenever like this compound, okay, complex is given. Whenever like this compound is given, dear students, then how to write? Check it. Okay, now, sir, which one is comes under, okay, which one is comes under cationic complex and which one is comes under, okay, what is, dear student, anionic complex? Like a small thing we have to consider. Whenever you are taking this one, okay, you must consider what is, dear student? This is neutral ligand. Neutral ligand, and whatever you are taking in this complex, always you have to consider this is a negative charged ligand. Negative charged ligand. Okay, now based on that you can easily calculate here. Okay, obviously we are understanding. Okay, this one there is no. Okay, what is charge? That's why you can consider this is what is positive. This is what negative. Then how to do it here? Okay, simple one. I am telling you here. Okay, now here zero. No, here chromium oxidation state. Generally, if you take it here zero. Normally, if you take the separate complex, correct or not? Okay, but here what is this one? COCl 6. That means here, okay, now I am having the 6 rupees. What is dear student? I am having 6 rupees. Okay, my friend also there. Okay, my friend also standing next to me only. Then we have to, okay, we have to share equally. How? 6 rupees means I am having the, okay, I have to take okay, half share, 3 rupees and one more person. Okay, the person one who are there next to me also, he has to take 3 rupees. 3 plus 3, what is dear student? 6. That means here, there are 6 negative ligands are there. How many? There are 6 negative ligands are there. Out of that 6, 1, 3 we have to give for this complex. Next one more 3 we have to take it this complex. That means here 6 is there or not? 6 out of 6 what I am taking here? 3 I am giving here, 3 I am taking this side. Correct? This one obviously always we have to take it here positive. Okay. Next one here always we have to take it. This is the negative. Easily check it here. This is cationic, this is anionic complex. Both are present or not? Both are present. Then how to take it here, dear students? Then like in this complex, how to write? Okay, now I can take it here. Hexa aqua. What is dear student? Hexa aqua. Okay. This is asterisk chromium. Hexa aqua chromium. Oxidation state, dear students, here 3. Asterisk you have to write. Hexa chromium 3. Hexa chromium 3. Next one, it is completed? No, only one part only got over. What about this complex? Okay, now what is the students here? Okay, 6. No, 6 means what is hexa Cl means chlorido. Hexa chlorido, but this is the what is the charge, dear student? Negative. That means called as anionic. Anionic means what will come here? Cobaltate will come or not? Cobaltate. Cobaltate. What is dear student? Cobaltate, oxidation state here 3. Okay, cobaltate. This is the IUPAC name of this compound. Hexa aqua, chromium, chromium. What is the oxidation state? 3. Total 6 is there, no? We have to share with 3. Here plus, here minus. Hexa aqua, chromium 3. Okay, hexa chlorido, cobaltate 3. Cobaltate 3. This is the way we have to write nomenclature. Got the clarity? Next one, some more example we have to discuss here. Correct? Okay, now you can take it here. Okay, CO NH3. Okay, 6 times NH3, 6 times. Okay, now I can consider here CR. Okay, CR you can consider here. What is you can consider CR Cl 6 times. CrCl 6 times. Correct or not? Then I can write here same hexa amine acetis. Here say here also same. Here 6, no? Here 3. Here 3 we have to. Here plus or minus. Hexa amine cobalt 3. Cobalt 3. Next one. Hexa chlorido. Hexa chlorido. Then negative charge for this, okay, chromium, no, central metal atom. What you have to write? Chromate will come or not? Chromate, oxidation state here 3. Oxidation state, dear student, this is the way you have to write for both anionic and as well as cationic, okay, complex is there. Next one, if you take it here, one more example, Ni, okay, H2O. 6 times H2O, 6 times. Take it here PT. Okay, now you can generally consider here PT Cl 6 times. Same. What do you have to write? Hexa aqua or aqua. Hexa aqua. Same. Nickel 3. Nickel 3. Sir, we have to consider only coordination number 6. No, you can consider coordination number 4 also. Next example I will give. Okay, next one. Hexachlorido. Okay, this is what will come. This is the negative node, dear student. This is the 3 minus, this is the 3 plus. Correct. Platinate will come or not? Platinate 3. Platinate 3. This is the way we have to write. Got the clarity? Next one. If you take it here, general. Okay. PT NH3 4 times. Generally we have to consider this first complex, dear student. Okay. Okay, neutral. Neutral ligand only we have to consider. Next one here. Ni. Understand? Cl4. NiCl4. Check it here. Here coordination number 4. Coordination number 4. Correct or not? Okay, I am having a 4 rupees. 2 persons are there. How we have to share it? 2 plus 2. That means obviously here 4 is there, no? 4 means here, here 2 and here 2. This is obviously comes under plus. This is obviously comes under minus. Then I can write it here, students, here. Tetraamine. PT stands for, dear students, platinum or not? Tetraamine. Platinum, tetraamine, platinum oxidation state 2, tetraamine, okay, platinum 2, next one, same, continue here, tetrachlorido, what will come, nickelate 2, okay, this is the way, okay, we have to, okay, write it, what is the, dear students, here, IUPAC nomenclature for different types of the complex. What is the student? Different types of the complex. Okay. Okay, this is the way we can write it here. If you are, okay, if you are continuous, okay, practice for the number of or different types of example, then you can easily note it down. You can easily calculate for any type of the complex. Any type of the complex. Okay, first of all, try to understand the concept, dear students. Nothing is there here. Okay, we calculated for anionic, cationic, neutral, and as well as if the both, okay, cationic and anionic complex is there, how to write? Everything we have done it or not? Everything we have done it here. Based on that, you can do it. No problem. This is our, what is the, dear students? Okay. Okay, nomenclature for this all, okay, different types of the complex. Okay, dear students, okay, please try to, okay, please note down, dear students, we can go for next concepts. Okay, thank you.